Say have fun in your podcast.
Fun in your podcast.
Say I love you.
I love you.
Do you hear that?
Yeah.
I'm trying to build my soundboard. Now you have brought the greatness of this app to me.
Right?
Yeah.
I wish I had more hands so I could give those titties four thumbs down.
Anyway, that's enough.
That's why I played around that shit the last episode when we're going into the rabbit hole on YouTube and shit. With the yee yee.
That's, oh yeah. So, but yeah. My bad, y'all. My like I said, I'm like my son. It's like one of the things where I knew he would get a scholarship somewhere. Like he was like getting offers from like smaller NAIA schools and like Division II schools in the area. But like, dog, when your daughter basically come up to you and say, "Hey, Dad, I got accepted to this program, and they gonna pay $60,000 a year for me to go to school." Nigga, what? I just like I said. So if my thoughts don't seem clear, cause they're not, I'm still trying to grasp it, bro. I'm still trying to grasp it, dog. Like I don't know. Like I really want to get Zakiya on the show, cause like. Bro, she's like so like bright and intelligent and precise, and her functioning and thinking, man, it's just like when you talk to her, when I talk to her sometimes, I gotta like remind myself, this is my daughter, so she's not an adult. So I don't wanna get too deep into the weeds with her. But she's good. As long as no fuckery comes her way, she'll be good.
Yeah. She'll be all right.
My sisters, you know, yeah, be all right. Blah, blah, blah. And it's like, but I get it. You're her aunties, and you supposed to, but I'm her daddy. You know what I'm saying? I'm her daddy. So, daddy don't ever, even with my son, though, like, it's not this day and age, but police have always been fucking with niggas. I still worry about him. He 2 hours away. In this small fuck town in, you know, Kansas, Iola, Kansas, I still worry about him, you know? Am I going to, like, I don't know if we talked about it where his roommate, I don't know if it was his roommate or a nigga in the building, as far as, like, there was a student in the building, student athlete in the building that was selling drugs. So they came, like, and confiscated all this shit from all these players, of course, black, and they confiscated his MacBook. That my sister, and my ex-wife had put in to buy him to go to school. They confiscated this shit. Niggas like, hold on, man. Why y'all snatching up my kid's shit that I didn't pay $600-$700 for him to have to help with his, you know, his academics? Well, it's part of a blah, blah, blah. So we had to hire a motherfucking lawyer to get his shit back for him, man, in this little whole dunk town in Iola. So, yeah, I mean, I worry about all my kids, man. It's fuckery to be had from the police, men, especially police and men who are police, you know what I'm saying? It's just fuckery to be had, you know what I'm saying? So you got to worry, bro. You got to worry. Like, and I see Logan, and it's like, is it bad? And I'm like, damn, I really hope, because I love you, I love Jamie, and it's like, damn, I hope when the police see him, they see more of the white in him than the Nicaraguan. Is that bad?
No, that's just a self-preservation, bro. I mean, that's...
I know, per se, I'm not his uncle, but I see myself as Uncle Roger, dog. And I look at that beautiful little boy. And I was at your house, that beautiful little boy in that chair. And I'm like, I really hope that the world, because I when I look at him, I see you. You know, I see you. And I see some of Jamie, too. But I definitely, for sure, see them them down south features, you know what I'm saying? And it's like, damn, you know, the way the U.S. is going, bro, I don't want the people who I love, especially their kids, to be fucked with, dog. I don't know how I handle it.
And hopefully we never get to
that. Hey, hold on, bro. My bad.
Hopefully we never get to that.
I think James just tried to call in.
James?
Yeah, hold on. Hold on, pimp. Go ahead, man. My bad. My screen erupted in.
No, and I think that's one of those things that, like, hopefully we as parents, yeah, we don't have to. Hopefully, as parents, we never have to face that shit. Hopefully, no parent should be able to face that shit. White, black, Asian, whatever the fuck you are, because you're right, though. Like, you know, what I mean, that shit. I mean, I have that. I know my wife doesn't really think about that a lot, but like, you know, we talked about this before. Like, I want my kid to be seen for who he is, not for how he looks. You know what I'm saying? It's like, mm-hmm. You know, I want my kid to have, like, whenever, if he ever becomes famous in whatever field or career he chooses, I don't want him to say, oh, he was brought up, you know, he's a minority. He was brought up in a one or two home. I want his background to be as normal in comparison to anybody else that they're going to compare him to, whether it be they be white, black, Asian, whatever, you know. And that's that. I mean, I feel you on that. It's like, when I see your kids, when I see our nephews, I mean, yeah, there might be white, there might be black or whatnot, but, or Latino, but I don't see him as that, you know what I'm saying? But part of me always goes back, and it's like, hey, look, you know, if Carter, my nephew, if he ever gets into the baseball field, you know, realm, he may not be taken serious because he's a white kid, you know what I mean? Unless he's a pitcher or a catcher or whatnot, you know, in the outfield, he's not going to be seen. You know, he might be overshadowed by a Latino or another black person or one that's more athletic than he is. And then my one of my nephews, Jonathan, he wants to be an FBI agent. And I'm like, and he has, and even at age 10, 8 or 9 that he is, he's already showing, he's already has the maturity and the mindset of, he can be an FBI agent. You know what I'm saying? He can do that. And I don't think it's something to laugh at or whatnot, but, and I take him serious, but the thing is, it's like, are they going to take you serious? You know what I mean?
Right.
And it's sad because it's not about what he knows or what he can do. It's going to be based on primarily of how he looks. And I'm like, man, that's the shame. You know, that's the shame that right now that's the world we live in, and we shouldn't be living in that. Hopefully by the time that they grow up, you know what I'm saying? It's different. Maybe I could be proven wrong, and I want to be proven wrong. But I feel you, man. And it's like, you're always going to worry. I mean, your daughter's going to be off to college, and, you know, to you take your last breath, but she's still going to be your little girl.
Oh, yeah.
And then, you know what I'm saying? And my boy Logan is going to be my little man till, I don't give a fuck if he's taller than me.
I'm gonna try to add James to this call. Hold on.
Go ahead. We're not live, so.
God damn it. It tells me that we're not live right now?
No.
Hold on.
Oh, shit. Are you there?
I'm here.
Everybody else here?
You there, James? Oh, he's still ringing in, I think.
Hold on.
Hey, you got this new Skype update?
Ben had it.
Oh, man.
Hold up, you there? I'm trying to add him right now. Are you there? Yo. Yo, are you there? to heal. What the hell just happened now? Hello?
What's up?
Who else is here?
Just me and you right now, I guess.
Who's this live?
That's supposed to be James, but I can't... Hold on, bro. Oh, God. I hate this new shit, bro. So that's Jay. He called me, missed call. You there, Frank?
I'm here.
In your Facebook Live, I'm gonna call. I don't know what's happening, dog. Invite more people. So I already tried to invite James. And of course they won't let me try to invite him because he's already supposed to be on this call. God damn it, nigga. I don't know what's happening, bro.
What's his name?
James Jefferson. But for some reason they got this live, whatever up. Who that is. Well, I'm on the side of my screen to say James Jefferson. Okay, except. There we go.
Well, I'm glad we're not live.
We're not live?
Well, no, we're not live. Like, we're not live
hold on. Podcasting. One more time. Hold on.
Yo.
Hello?
We here?
You there, James? God damn it.
Hello.
You there? Oh. You there, James?
Yeah, I'm here.
All right, turn your camera on, James. This Skype update is fucking doo doo, nigga.
So, turn your camera on, James.
I know, I forgot how to do it.
Are you on your phone?
Yeah.
If you're on your phone, you ain't got to. If you're on your phone, I think you got to turn like the landscape or landscape mode or whatever.
Yes.
You ain't got to do it.
Last time.
You ain't got to do it.
You're all right. Welcome back, though, man.
All right, I appreciate it.
We know who you are. We know who you are.
So
anyway, go ahead, Frank.
So now that we have you on here, what the hell were we talking about before he came on? Oh, we're talking about police officers and stuff like that and kids.
About the guy at the hotel.
No, I was gonna go. That was gonna be the segue. I don't know if Frank didn't know that was gonna be my segue. No. But we were just talking about like our kids and just like my daughter, she got that scholarship. And she's gonna be this nigga got a nice cup. I see you. My daughter about to be over in Pennsylvania, and then I was talking about how even though she's further away, Amaz now in like Iola, Kansas, and how he's been fucked with by the police, and we had to get lawyers because somebody in his dormitory was trying to sell drugs. Wasn't him? Wasn't his roommate? Some nigga trying to sell drugs, whatever. To basically. All the black athletes there, they fuck with, confiscate all their shit. And so, like, when he graduated, like, me, my sisters, and then my ex-wife had, like, put money up to get him a nice little MacBook to go to school. So the cops confiscated his MacBook, dog. So we had to get a lawyer to get his computer out of holding, bro. And it's like...
Really?
Yeah, for real. Nigga, like, yeah, real spit. And it's like... Shit like that. I mean, like, I worry about my son, like, traveling from Topeka, Kansas to Iola, Kansas. Nigga, it's a 3-hour trip, dog. I worry about that shit, man. And, like, of course, I worry about my daughter being 18 hours away, but I worry about my a black man in Kansas in this small ass, fuck ass town. Yeah,
just going to a place called Iola just don't sound right. Like, where are you going?
But we had this talk when you went there. I'm like, you understand, dog. You going to Iola, Kansas, nigga. He's like, yeah, blah, 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 this thing. I'm like, yeah, when you on campus, you the man. Soon as you step off campus, you a nigga. That's it. And he learning.
Mm-hmm.
It is an echo now.
There's an echo.
It went away, but my bad. But we'll figure it out.
Kind of stuff on my screen.
You know, James over there jacking off.
I'm not doing nothing, man. I'm up here looking at somebody's computer screen.
Anyway, yeah, hold on. My bad. Anyway, we got a late. James is out making sure the trap is clean, making sure the crack house is clean, making sure all his holes is on point. Ready to get this Christmas money. And now that they are, he has blessed us once again with his presence. Yeah. Hey, dog, but thank you for coming through, though, dog. We appreciate it.
Oh, no problem.
Always the more than Larry.
And yes, James is the one, and that's why I fuck with him, because we are the people that were arguing back and forth for like an hour and a half about Bernie.
When I listen to that, I'm like, man, we were just going and going.
Hey, nah, but that's the thing. But people don't realize that face-to-face, we used to argue about shit like that all the time.
Face-to-face, this shit would have been like full-on confrontational, face-to-face, finger-pointing, and getting in your face.
People thought that we didn't like each other because we argue so hard.
Yeah, but the thing is, like, it's like... Yeah, but people don't realize when niggas fuck with each other, we poke each other the hardest.
Dog, I told you that my wife. My remember when you used to come over to your apartment? Me and you would get into heated conversations. Dog, we would just louder.
Jamie be like, "What are y'all doing out here? We just talking about football."
Dog, and you could tell, like, people probably, like, you know, my neighbors on below us and below, above me, well, hey, they're probably waiting to call the cops. Dog.
The best slash worst thing was when that motherfucking Niehaus got so mad. Hold on. Hey, James, I'm a Missouri fan. Die hard. And this other dude, he was a Missouri fan, diehard. We got into a fight about who should be. We got into a fight about the play that should have been called. He got so mad, he walked home in the middle of the winter, dog.
You're not supposed to get that deep.
Bruh, I was like, no. He's like, fuck this, I'm leaving.
Nah, the booze was already flowing, though. It was already flowing, like hard, too.
Hey, Frank is the devil, dog, because, like, he gets you there, gets you your house, nigga. He had the Grey Goose. He had, like, motherfucking, like, nice, no Miller Lite, nigga, nice beer. So you be about 4 or 5 fucking, like, 6 point percentage of beers in. You did a couple of Grey Goose shots in. Yeah, and craft beers in. And you had a couple of Grey Goose shots in, and before you know it, the nigga that was on your side, you like, fuck you, nigga. This nigga shouldn't even be calling plays.
No, but anyway, so we were talking about cops, man, and I want to say this now. I say this story from the South Carolina police officer that shot up at that time, Officer Scott could be seen running. No, excuse me, Scott could be seen running from Officer Slager as the officer fired a barrage. I don't know if you guys remember this one. This was a South Carolina police officer that just opened fire.
But I was trying. Hold on, but who are you talking about? Because James was talking about the recent one.
Oh, I'm talking about this one that just got convicted 20 years. That they actually held him accountable for that shit.
20 years, which is a good thing. So go ahead and talk about that. Then we'll talk about the backside, the other side of it.
I don't know what the backside of. I just know that, you know, in the environment that we live in right now, you know, with the one police officer in Tulsa, the female that just got away, you know, she was not found guilty, and then she went to another police department, and now she's working there. You know, we finally see this white police officer that, you know, got 20 years, dog. So I don't know what's to be made of that. I mean, I just feel like I do appreciate that they asked the kid's input into it. And he says it doesn't matter how many years he goes into jail. I still wake up missing my dad. That shit cuts deep, dog.
So you heard about this Daniel Shaver shit, right?
Which one?
Daniel Shaver. Yeah, I'm getting feedback now. All of a sudden.
Yeah, man, I'm starting to get a lot of choppiness.
Hold up, let me refresh. Oh, yeah. Are you getting that, Frank?
Yeah, I'm getting it. I mean, I hear you. I get a little bit of feedback, but not anymore.
What about you, James?
I'm just getting, like, choppiness in the audio. Like, you're cutting in and out.
You got to leave the basement, bro. It
might be your connection. Hold on.
I think it is because I think, it came up and said it had a poor connection.
Yeah.
So, you just put audio on.
Not cooperate.
Oh, so you online looking up Daniel Shaver right now?
Yeah, that fucker, dog.
So this happened. You there, James?
I'm still here.
Yeah, it's breaking up. Hold on. Maybe it's me. How do I refresh this? 1, 2, 1, 2. Okay, I'm good. You said that, James?
Yeah. I don't know if you can really hear me.
Okay, so Frank just looked it up. You already knew about headphones? It, right, James?
I'm having issues.
It's okay. So Frank, I think James already knew about it because he was talking about it on my feed on Facebook. So 2016, the hotel, police respond to a report of someone pointing a gun out the window. Philip Brailsford was one of the responding officers. In the video, you see to hear the cops barking out commands to a man, Daniel Shaver, and a woman. In the moment they walk out of their room. So long story short, dog. So like, I give a little personal testimony here. So thank goodness it's only been a few times I've been pulled by the police. One time I had to get out of my car and do the whole back out, crawl out the window, get on the ground, out in front of my mama's house, no less. And when they did it, it was in such a way that get out of the ground, get out of your car, get on the ground. And when I got on the ground, put my hands out, a cop got there and put my hands behind my head, handcuffed me. Long story short, somebody had stole a white vehicle, a white SUV. At that time, I had a Ford Explorer. It was white. Somebody stole a, I don't know what it was. They stole a white SUV in close to that area. So they were looking for that. Thank goodness the police at that time gave me very simple commands to follow. And at that point, they still could have shot me. Who knows? But what? No, stand up, sit down, scratch your ass, scratch right. One ear.
They were giving this dude sit down, turn around, turn left.
Yeah. Like red. I'm gonna play some of the sound. I mean, we're not a audio video show. I was gonna play some of the audio, but I was just giving that. You know, of course, I was just giving that to say. At that point in time, they gave me very simple, direct commands: turn the vehicle. Hey, roll your window down. Turn the vehicle off. Throw the keys out the window. Open the door. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Come out the door. Back up. Face your vehicle. Back up towards me. Stop. Get on your knees. Lay down on the ground. Put your hands out on your sides. Don't move. Then somebody, I could hear, you know, people moving, you know what I'm saying? People came up, handcuffed me. The whole, I'm a smart nigga, because I know, like, I'm not going to ask niggas questions that got guns put on me. Once I was handcuffed and I realized I'm not a fucking threat anymore, I said, what's going on? What's happening? Somebody said, shut the fuck up. So I shut the fuck up. Even though I should have no reason to shut the fuck up, I shut the fuck up.
All right.
And they picked me up, pulled me back to the car. And they said, why, they were like, why were you backing up into this driveway? I'm like, well, first of all, my mama lives here. I'm visiting her. I was backing up my truck so that way I can load my truck up in the morning to leave when I leave here at 4 a.m. Oh, okay. Well, do you know that somebody in this area stole the vehicle, blah, 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 blah? And I'm like, why would I know that?
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, nigga. Well, I know that, like, they kind of, like, they chuckle, but I'm, like, kind of pissed off, you know? And then, like, one dude said, there was one, and I was, like, you know, I ain't no small nigga, as both of y'all know. And so it was, like, one dude, I was bigger than everybody there. He was, like, well, I'm glad you didn't put no fight up. I said, I'm not stupid. I see 8 police with 8 guns pointed at me. I ain't the Hulk, nigga.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
You sure ain't bouncing any bullets off of you.
Ain't no bullets bouncing off me. So, like I said, all that to say that at least they were, I guess, professional in their commands, I guess. So that's lack of a better word. Mm-hmm. I don't have no words to describe it, but they gave me clear commands on what to do, when to do it, get on the ground, and once they had me secured, everybody put their guns up, and we began to talk. So I'm gonna play some of this video. Have you heard this, Frank?
No, I've seen it before though, but this will probably be the first time that I'll hear with you guys.
No, I've seen it and heard it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, okay, here we go. Hold on.
Stop! Get on the ground, both of you. Lay down on the ground. Lay down.
So okay, so I don't know if y'all we're not. Hold on, should I share my screen with y'all? Well, James ain't got a screen, but because that's special, right, fucking our feed that's, up.
That one's mine. That one's mine.
So right now, the police says stop, get on the ground. So right now, the man, he's on the ground, both hands up. What do you think the cops should do?
Go over and cuff him.
What?
So once he's down on the ground prone like that, yeah, it says like 8 cops there. Somebody goes over, you check him, and you cuff.
Bruh. If on this video, so if I'm in this jury, I'm trying to figure out, this man didn't say nothing. He didn't buck. He didn't plead. He didn't say nothing. And y'all both have seen it, but I'm just, for everybody else out there who hasn't seen it, this man got on the ground, both hands up, hands open, facing to the police, face flat, like if he's a baby with no head control, my nigga. Y'all both seen it, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so y'all both seen, so we'll continue on.
Hold on.
What'd you say?
It's good to point out that
God damn it.
That this guy's gonna be the guy that's on the ground, it's not a person of color.
But and that's the beauty of it though, because that we'll talk about it after that. Okay. We'll talk about it after that.
Because I have a point to make on that.
All right. So once again, the cop says, stop, get on the ground. And we see in the video, the man on the ground, both hands on the floor. And the cop now says, I see we have a problem with you having failure that could follow simple instructions. Okay, I continue.
Yes.
All right, if you make a mistake, another mistake, there's a very severe possibility that you're both going to get shot. Do you understand that?
Come on.
All right. This is, shut up. I'm not here to be tactful or diplomatic with you. You listen, you obey.
What?
Right. What is he doing? What is he talking about?
I didn't want to. I'm already drawing the line and in the sand. And my line has been drawn with the weapon I'm now pointing at your face. All right, I'm going to keep playing.
For one thing, did I tell you to move, young man? Did I tell you to put both your hands on the top of your head and interlace your fingers? Take your feet.
Which he does.
Cross your left foot over your right foot. Who else is in the room? Are you both drunk?
No.
All right. So you're not going to have any...
Hold up. Are you both drunk? How am I supposed to know if this bitch drunk? I may not know if I'm drunk. We talking about, am I drunk legally by the law? Am I going to blow .08? What are you... You should be... Have you both been drinking? Yes. Are you both drunk? That's a whole nother set of chemistry panels that we ain't got going on right now.
This officer obviously has no idea how to conduct himself properly.
I'm looking at the weapon that he's holding now. Why does he have an assault rifle?
All the cops got that shit now, bro.
They have it in the trunk, but unless you're told to use it, you ain't supposed to reach for it. Okay.
Where you been the last two years, bro?
They've been militarizing the police department pretty heavily over the last 2 years.
No, I know that. I'm just saying that's not protocol.
This ain't England where you got to get permission to get the motherfucking gun out the boot.
But that's what I'm saying, though. It's like, that's not...
Yeah, you got to call in. Yeah, in England, you got to call out the squad.
Yeah, because in England, they don't carry guns.
No.
Not everybody does. But that's
not
what I'm
everybody
saying.
Does. This is America, though.
That's what we, with them, like, that's the shit that goes into the trunk. They carry their pistols on them, but...
No, dog, they got pistols on, but even back in the 80s and 90s, my dad, my pops, they had motherfucking shotguns up in the front. They just locked.
Oh, right. No, I don't know about that. Okay.
Oh, they just had some cat, some cruiser left their doors open, and this dude pulled out a whole arsenal full of weapons and ran off with them. It's on tape.
Yeah, dog, they got
recently.
They acting like this a war zone for real.
Yeah, well, shotgun, assault white weapons, vest, everything was sitting open in the car, the cruiser.
If we're
even though police deaths have been down over the last, 4 or 5 years, mm-hmm. they acting like it's a full-blown war.
Well, just us having a discussion about, a disagreement about, like, what the protocol is, then that goes to show you there's something wrong, though. If we don't know offhand what the fuck they're supposed to be doing and what we're supposed to be doing.
Nigga, why is the SWAT team showing up to a fucking hotel fucking like
ISIS?
Like, niggas got too loud a hotel.
They got ISIS.
Somebody heard that there was a gun being pointed out the window.
That's right. You're right. My bad.
It's ISIS.
Hold on. I'm going to keep playing, though.
I know why, but still, and then it doesn't necessarily a SWAT team, though.
Hold on. I'm going to keep playing. Hold on.
Behind your head. You are to keep your feet crossed. If you move, we're going to consider that a threat.
Okay. Everything so far so good, right? If you move, you get shot.
Right. Nigga, if you tell me not to press the red button, though.
Nigga, if you got a gun on me.
You tell me not to breathe, dog. I'm going to be like...
Nigga, if you got a gun on me, tell me not to breathe, nigga. I'm gonna be the most non-breathing nigga ever.
Okay.
Okay, here we go.
He's about to really set him up for failure, though. Here.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. So
that's what it was.
Young lady, shut up and listen. Right? You are to keep your feet crossed. Take both of your hands, put them flat in front of you. You are to push yourself up to a kneeling position.
First of all, but hold on, my man. You just told me not to move.
Mm-hmm.
You told me to lay down, not move. Oh, now I'm supposed to lay down and move?
But he told her, he said, now, young lady.
Nigga, mm-hmm. he said to them, put your feet down, push yourself up to another position. I'm like, hold on, my nigga. You just said, don't move.
Rewind it.
Okay, I rewind it, nigga. Oh, goddamn. I hate MacBook sometimes. Let's rewind and debate.
Right. You are to keep your feet crossed.
No, go back a little bit more.
Put them flat, move. We're going to consider that a threat. And we are going to deal with it, and you may not survive it. Do you understand me?
Damn.
Young lady, wow. And listen. Right? You are to keep your feet crossed. Take both of your hands, put them flat in front of you. You are to push yourself up to a kneeling position. Kneeling position. Now, put both your hands in the air. Okay,
you're right, Frank, but I would say once again, if you have...
Okay.
Hold on. Oh, go ahead, James, go ahead.
I'm just saying, okay, now, you scared... You've been drinking. Now you're being given intricate instructions by someone that's pointing assault weapons at you. You may not, follow through, totally to the letter that he wants you to. And if you don't, he's basically threatening to kill you. I mean, you're in a lose-lose right now.
You're in a lose-lose right now. And I say from the other side, that's why I'm about to say, hey, Frank. So, Frank, you didn't kick in those. You didn't clear out some shit. So, if you got two suspects on the ground obeying your commands, why would you have them go to a kneeling position?
No. I just wanted to make sure that we clarified that he gave the directions to both of them.
No, initially, he distinguished
by like now when he said now, ma'am, he was talking to the lady.
No.
That's why on the video you don't see the guy moving at all. That's all I wanted to make sure.
No, that's why I said off top, you're right. I fucked up. But I'm saying is from a person who then kicked in those, who has cleared out buildings, why would you have two suspects that you got a gunpoint on the ground, hands open, spread out? Why would you now have them up?
We were under different conditions, though. Like,
no, no, I'm saying though, if I got you under command and control,
I'm saying that we knew we weren't going to take any hostages or any witnesses.
Forget all that. If I got you under command and control, if I seen you come out of a room and now I got you on the gunpoint, I told you to get on the ground and y'all both got on the ground, y'all both belly flat, hands out to the side. Why now am I going to tell y'all both to get up?
Doesn't make any logical sense.
It doesn't.
I get Iraq, totally different, right? Totally different. But even with that, you can take the next step to say, if I got command and control, I have seen you exit a room, and you ain't got no motherfucking buttons, you ain't got no detonator, you ain't got this, you ain't got no guns, no grenades, blah, 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 this, this, and that. And I told you to get on the ground, on your bellies, and you follow all my commands up until that point. No hesitation. Why now all of a sudden am I telling you to cross legs, pull yourself up?
I don't know.
Right, exactly.
I don't know. I mean,
the handcuffs should be going on.
Mm-hmm.
And from there, we ask some questions.
Right.
But that's not the case. We only halfway through the video, so we continue. Yeah.
I wish you shared a video so I could see it.
I thought you had it. You got it up on the screen?
Yeah, but I don't have the the verbiage.
Come on back. So during this time, no, really. The man is still on the ground. Can y'all both hear it? You know when
you're clear. Yeah, I can share your screen.
Okay. Young man, listen to my instructions and do not make a mistake.
At this time, he has not moved at all.
You are to keep your legs crossed. Do you understand me? You are to put both of your hands, palms down, straight out in front of you. Push yourself up to a kneeling position. I said, keep your legs crossed!
So, I don't know if you know, but if you're not very athletic, if you ain't been to the latest NFL motherfucking combine,
right,
you may or may not slightly uncross your legs when someone tells you to push them up. Or you may not be thinking about it when this nigga having the gun pointed at you.
Mm-hmm.
And if you look at the video, this nigga is clearly shook when this officer raises his voice. I'm like, hold on, wait a minute. I didn't do what you told me to do? And I continue. Sorry. I'm sorry. To everyone out there, to the 8 people, 10 people, 12 people who may be listening, at this point in time, I'm telling you, just fall down on the floor with your hands out.
Don't do anything else.
Just fall down on the floor with your hands out.
That's exactly what I would have done.
I have been in these fucking these chat groups. I have been on Facebook. I have been on where niggas have been posting these videos. I have seen these motherfuckers talking about he was grabbing this, grabbing that, grabbing this, and I'm like, I'm trying to figure out what are you talking about, my man? What are you talking about, my lady, I get it. You got a husband. I get it. You a cop. But don't be blind to the fact that this man fucking followed what the cop said. So anybody else out there, fall down on the ground, put your hand straight out, don't say shit. I know it sounds submissive. I know it sounds whatever the fuck, but if
save your life, though.
Save your life, or you have a better chance of getting this motherfucker. Because you're going to get nine times out of ten, if this nigga is this mother, when I say nigga, nigga to me, and James knows, white people, white person, this nigga, this mother, ignorant motherfucker, is meant to shoot. He wants to shoot somebody today. The only thing you saving is the next thing you're getting shot. Because if you fall down to the ground, your hands out wide, and he shoots you in the head, ain't no question he gonna shoot him nigga in the head that day.
Duh, how didn't I get a conviction after not only watching the video, but after the verbiage of saying, bro, I am not here to be tactical or diplomatic.
I know you're not on Facebook and the thing, that's why I keep both a Facebook and a Twitter, because Twitter dismisses a lot of that bullshit off top. Facebook allows a lot of this bullshit, and then it slowly dismisses it. So what they saying is when he reached his hands behind his back, he was reaching for a gun. There's a lot of people who are saying this, even though no gun was found, and it's never a gun found. We all know this, but if you go to Facebook, because go through our Nicaraguan account, which you have control of for the most part. Go on there and look up some of these videos, bro, and look at the comments, and you'll see the sickness, dog. The sickness that allows this shit to continue to happen.
But this goes back to, in our episodes before, is that that's the shit that I'm not gonna engage in with those people, man. I'm not gonna give him the time of day, though.
No. I'm not telling you to engage in it. Don't comment, because I don't want to deal with this. But yeah, go ahead.
No, I was gonna say on my Facebook feed, you know, I don't just have like pages that I agree with. I look at other things too. You know, I check out InfoWars.
You said porn? Other
right wing conservative views that don't align with mine, just to see what they're saying. I don't engage with them, but I do check. I read the comments and I see what they're saying. That gives me perspective on exactly what the thinking is going on. I hate to put it like this, but if you don't know what your enemy is thinking, you don't know how to combat them. Basically, is my philosophy.
But if you want to combat them, that means you're ultimately looking to see how to engage them.
You guys saying the same thing, I believe.
And when I mean engage them, it doesn't necessarily mean in a violent way, but how to approach them based on their state of mind. I want to know state of mind of that person that may possibly be opposing me.
And I guess I could respect that, but I guess like where I'm at right now, the point in life that I'm in is I'm not even gonna give him that time of day. Like, I don't need to understand.
Go ahead. My bad.
For me, right? Like, for me, ultimately, I'm not saying that I know everything. And you're right, though. I should be educating myself to understand, like, you know, how I arrived at the decision that I made or whatnot. But when to me, right is right, wrong is wrong. And I
agree.
And you're right. And I guess that if I know if my thinking is, hey, I'm right, my way of thinking is the right way, how did the opposition, which I'm calling the opposition, how did they arrive to their point? I could get with that. I could dig that.
Hey, okay, you already got there. You were saying, you my bad. Sometimes I'd be like, I got to shut the fuck up. But you're right. But you just said it. Though. It's like when I'm looking at this video and I'm seeing this man go through these actions, and it's like when I hear that the police officer ain't getting no time, my first question is how. So of course I gotta go. I look at the video. I go how, and then I go to the comments, and the comments shows me how we get to this point. And it's like people are just filling in the gaps with just pointless bullshit. He reaching for this, he reaching for that. And it's like if I'm like, hey, look here, man. I'm in decent shape. Maybe I can get up from a knee point, but a regular
overweight, I wouldn't be able to. Not with my weak ass ankles.
He ain't about to just raise himself up, and I had to fucking like, hold on, wait a minute, I'm off balance. You know what I'm saying?
But and honestly, from the video, it looked like he was like his maybe his pants were falling down, and he was reaching to pull his pants up. Yeah, I honestly think that's what he was doing.
But I always go back to the point, like even like I've never like I work. Like Bosnia was like the cause like even like my two times in Iraq, I never had a working control point, but Bosnia I had a working control point. Like that's the few times I had like pat people down, do shit like that, throw a motherfucker on the ground, pat them down, whatever. And the whole thing was get a nigga on the ground, gain control, and then from there you do your search, right?
Mm-hmm.
Why would I have somebody get up to do a search?
Yeah, but remember though, when you're in those situations, you have like a gang of arsenal behind you. Bruh, in this case,
bruh. No. When I was in Bosnia, dog, it was me and like two other motherfuckers in a room. Yeah,
that's true.
And the other motherfucker had to be like making sure nobody else was rolling up on the gate. It wasn't just throwing the motherfuckers. You know what I'm saying? But even then, even if I had 90 niggas in a room, the SOP in the training dictated if I suspect you to have a weapon, it's going to cause me or anybody in this room harm. Get you on the ground, get your hands out, and pat you the fuck down. If I find a wire, we leave in the room, nigga, and we bring an EOD in to clear everything out. You know what I'm saying? So as I look at this video, there's no reason this man should had ever at any point in time had to get back up. You know what? I'll play the rest so we can finish off. It's like 40 more seconds.
Hands straight up in the air. Do not put your hands down for any reason.
His hands are straight up.
I would have put this officer to the death penalty, though.
It'll never happen.
Like, there's a reason why I'm not a judge in these type of situations, though.
And anybody who looks at this video, I'm like, tell me at one point in time when this officer's life was in risk or in harm, nigga. And I hate to be selfish, dog, but I think about myself, like, in front of my mama's house that night, and that cop made that joke of, you big. I'm glad you didn't decide to do this, and that. And I'm just like, y'all really think motherfuckers are superhumans out this motherfucker? Y'all really come here with so much fear in your fucking hearts, dog? While me and my brethren over in some other country getting blown the fuck up, dog. And y'all just out here in these streets, nigga, just like... and we got more rules and laws and regulations and SOPs dictating what we can and can't do. And y'all just out here just fucking yippee-yay-kay-yay-yay at this motherfucker, dog. Mm-hmm. It's... Dog,
I mean,
nigga,
listening...
My bad, go ahead, James, my bad. Say,
just listening to that last part was really like hearing him crying, basically.
Begging for his life, bruh.
Like, begging for his life, yes, sir. And you can hear the tears. I mean, I'm sure the tears are probably on the way if they weren't already falling. And this is the guy that you think is about to pull a weapon on you? He's clearly distraught and trying to do his best to follow your instructions.
That's why I again want to say, I say again, my nigga, dog. If I think you got a weapon, I got you belly on the ground, hands out, face down. I got this woman who you thought may have been in danger out the way, I'm not telling you to get up. I'm coming to you with the weapon to your dome. And I'm going to have my homeboy pat you down.
Right. It's not like he was by himself.
Why is that not posture procedure? I know. I'm just like, I'm going to have you crawl towards me.
No. And you get down on the ground, spread, you know, whatever, lace your hand, whatever. And then, okay, I got you covered, so-and-so. Let's cuff him. Let's check him.
Why can't, like, niggas who be like, not niggas. I ain't met no niggas that be like, this is cool. But, like, motherfuckers that be like this, and that. Maybe. I'm like, I can't fuck with you, dog. I can't fuck with you because you don't value my life, any other life, over whatever fucking police bullshit policy you got in your brain. Anyway.
Okay. I do have a point to make in terms of the colorism of the racial element here going on.
Yeah.
I have noticed, because I do read these comments from, you know, the right-wing conservative, you know, pages, that in this case, with this guy, and I'm going to say it because I think because he's white, they are not backing this cop like they do in all the other cases when it involves somebody of color.
Oh, that's always a start, though. That's always a start, bro. You know that.
And I've been saying for a long time, it's a trickle-down thing. They're not just going to come for us. Once they start feeling like they have carte blanche to do whatever they want and there's no rules, everybody's in danger. It don't matter what your color is anymore.
We talked about it before, though, but look at the whole thing of all this sexual harassment shit that came up. It wasn't because black women. It's because white women, who a lot of other white women like, was getting touched on. Then it became a problem.
Mm-hmm.
Did nobody care about R. Kelly pissing on kids on tape?
Nah.
Fuck that. Did nobody care about Bill Cosby drugging a couple of motherfucking women who black, white, but less known actresses, or some of them ain't even get a chance to be actresses. Did nobody care about that? When your fave getting fucked with, that's when everybody care. When the motherfucker who look like the nigga who play ball with your son get fucked with, that's when everybody care.
Mm-hmm.
I'm about to piss y'all off real quick. Real quick. I'm reading these comments, though.
I told you, bro. I read the comments, bro.
This one, Demon X Prayer, says, this police officer was well-trained. He went by the book! ! Women followed instructions equal lived. The guy didn't follow instructions equal killed. Simple as that.
But then you read the next thing. Simon says, hey, shoot the person. But once again, dog, and I always say,
that's a ridiculous notion that there's just like this black and white thing that if you don't follow it's just to the T that you deserve to be killed. That's stupid. Again, it makes no sense.
You're right. They're like, pissed, dog. Like, I can't. And the thing about it is, like, even if I comment on this shit, because I've been drinking, like I wouldn't be able to. Like, I don't know if this is like my real emotion or this is like alcohol driven.
It's like a deep rabbit hole. It's a pit. Once you get started, you'll be in there fighting with them all night.
Exactly. No, but I'm saying it's like because I've been drinking.
But even more than that, though, it's social media, and everyone on there knows they'll never have to face you. So everyone becomes this superhero bad guy. Yeah. It's like I got into a nigga on one of my friends' Facebook things, and come to find out we both live in Kansas City.
Look at
this nigga was popping. This nigga was popping shit, and he was like, "Well, nigga, I know you local." And I'm like, "Okay, and nigga, I ain't never hear the fact that I am local. What's up, nigga?"
Look at this one. CZ_man. They should have had him sing the national anthem backwards. Shoot him for that. Save a lot of tax. I mean, and he put sarcasm at the bottom of it, but
you know what I mean? Yeah, but I think he's just proving the point there. But like a lot of niggas pop that shit. But like I said, like even my own personal dealings, I had niggas and it's like, yeah, nigga, I see you local, and I'm like, okay, and what's up, nigga? I told my one nigga, I was like, hey, bro, these your friends, I ain't gonna fucking whatever. But can see a very small pace, nigga. And I'm gonna see these niggas at one point in time. And it never fails. Whenever I say that, niggas stop responding. I'm not saying I'm the most fit nigga. I can fight any nigga. I got a gun and I'm a big nigga, dog.
I already told you, dog. Me and you ever get in a fight, I'm using a bat, nigga. Fuck that. Mm-hmm. I'm taking out your knees, dog. If I don't have a gun, I'll get a bat and I'm taking out your knees, dog.
But I also always say, dog, this is, I'm like, look, nigga.
If me and you ever fight, dog, it's not going to be a fair one.
I don't want to fight a nigga. I'm like, nigga, I'm 40 years old, dog. I'm not about to fight a nigga over this shit here. But if you approach me, it is what it is, dog.
No, I
got to get home, dog. The mission
No, yeah, is you got to get home. Yeah, you right. I feel you. That's our motto here at the Nicaraguan. Get home. Whatever you need to do.
Get home, dog. But it's like, niggas, whatever. We getting off topic, dog.
No,
like,
fuck that. If I ever fight you or anybody that looks like you, I'm taking out the knees, dog, with a bat. Now, it's not going to be a fair fight.
The main objective is that we become a society of motherfuckers that niggas should say whatever and go to work and never feel accountable for that shit, though, dog.
Yeah, when they feel there's no consequence.
There is no consequence. Right. I say whatever, and then every once in a while, niggas get found out. It's like, oh, I didn't mean to offend anybody. It's like, how did you think saying that niggas should die in hell? Right.
You know what I mean? And every once in a while, they get fired from a job, or, you know, they get shamed. They get harassed a little bit.
If my words offended anyone, I am so sorry.
Right. Like anyone. The chick
here at the Nicaraguan podcast, we're endorsed.
In Atlanta, nigga.
Yeah, and that
words.
Hey,
and she slapped back on it.
Hey, white women gonna learn. White women and men gonna learn to leave black women alone, dog. Because niggas know. Just sometimes you gotta go to the downstairs and just shut the fuck up.
and she did it slick because she made sure that she put her that they showed her email address.
Uh huh.
When was this? Hold on. What was this?
Hey, nigga, Maury is all of 5 foot, 100-some-odd pounds, nigga, but even I shut the fuck up.
Mm-hmm. you know what I'm wondering over here? Because I looked at this, the statement here. The one about, where was it? I just saw it. Motherfucker, though.
What are you talking about?
Oh, here, the one that the quote that says the justice system miserably failed Daniel Shaver and his family said that Mark Garagos, an attorney for Shaver's widow. So I'm wondering if they got to the widow, like, you know,
that strange moment when everyone realized that Black Lives Matter was just saying that, hey, if you keep letting them kill us, they're going to kill you.
But no, you eventually.
No, what I'm saying is that Shaver's widow, because he was found in a hotel room with another woman that he had just met.
Yeah, they just trying to shame him, though. I'm saying that's that whole thing we talked about last week, 1+1=cat shit. What'd that guy do with anything?
I'm saying what they probably did to her was like, yo, we going to pay you off, just ride with this statement. You know what I mean?
But once again, even if he was in there fucking kittens in the ass, nigga, it don't matter.
Right, but to her, like the lady, I don't know his situation. I don't know her situation. You know, the cops could have been like, "Yo, we're gonna pay you off."
I hear what you're saying. I'm saying it's a smokescreen. That's all I'm saying. It's a smokescreen. Yeah. It's being deterred from the fact that this man followed every instruction and he got shot in the motherfucking head.
Mm-hmm.
It's like I said. It's the we were talking about last week. 1+1=cat shit, bro. It don't matter. This motherfucker came in here, gun drawn.
Right. Escalating the situation the whole time. When you should be doing the opposite.
If you move, if you fart,
If you motherfucking burp, you get shot in the face.
How many times did he threaten to shoot him? At least 4 times he threatened to shoot him.
And I just want to be said and want to be acknowledged on this podcast that we are equally pissed and angered regardless of the color.
Yeah.
No, I don't think anybody should
be shooting shot. Period.
Yeah, but I think it's important that we mention that.
And it's not the same. And it's because, and it really pisses me off more because the police are the ones that are supposed to be trained and have a special mandate to protect the public.
Mm-hmm. Protect and serve is on their
they're
fucking.
They're not just some guy on the street that's going out killing people. That's different. This is somebody that's supposed to be trained and given a special mandate to protect the public, and they're not doing it. They're doing the opposite.
It's motherfuckers saying, "How much can I get away with?"
Right, and how much can I get away with? And everybody's letting them get away with it, from the administration to the prosecutors that I swear are throwing these cases so that they don't piss off the police department and they don't get help on other cases. I know that's happening.
Yeah, that's probably true.
I think it's a whole issue.
It is a trade-off between the DA and the police officers. They know right. that shit.
And there should be like a special prosecutor's office just for these police misconduct things.
Hey, hold on. I'll be right
back. You mean like internal review?
There should be an independent like state prosecutor's office just for handling police misconduct cases. And they should be independent and not have to answer to anybody except for, you know, the governor, whatever.
You're right.
And not beholden to any police department where they might be influenced to not do their job correctly.
Yeah, but, you know, I agree with you on that. But, you know, ultimately, somehow, some way, they're going to be somehow fucking corrupted too.
But at least you got to set up the mechanism. They don't even have the mechanism set up.
Yeah, because even though, like, what they have, like, them internal reviews or whatever, you know what I mean? You know, they're always going to look out for their buddies, you know what I mean? Because it serves them no purpose,
man, what are you talking about, like internal affairs, whatever?
Yeah.
But they can't, they don't prosecute. You know, they're not attorneys. They're not prosecutors.
But they're supposed to be reviewing the case and bring charges. They can do departmental
discipline, but there's not going to be any arrest or anything like that.
Yeah. And you're right. I agree with you. I'm already pissed off just watching this video.
Now, listening to that again, like listening to him, that kind of shook me.
No, it did, bro.
Like basically crying and begging not to get shot and getting shot. Yeah, that was pretty disturbing.
No, it is, man. It's like, I mean, it's disturbing because, you know, you in your right mind and me in my right mind, we're like, yo, we probably would have not. It doesn't matter. Like for example, like I've been in that situation before. I've been in a heightened situation, like where I don't know necessarily my enemy, but I know the direction they're coming from. But I don't know the next person that comes out if they're gonna be enemy or not. So I've been in that heightened my awareness has been heightened, and my finger next to the trigger. You know what I'm saying? But I didn't squeeze it. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like I've been in that, and those scenarios right. that people talk about, like, well, you mm-hmm. ever been in that situation? I'm like, no, I haven't, but I've been in a similar one. Like, but I'm here, mm-hmm. and the person that came across from me, then I didn't shoot them. So, mm-hmm. so from my perspective, it's gonna be like, you're right. We're supposed to be well trained, and we're supposed to trust the fact that we're training these folks, our police department, our law enforcement, that we're training them, just like. In my everyday job, I'm being trained on certain scenarios. I'm a contracting officer, but we train on different scenarios and how to handle them and whatnot. I'm pretty sure in your line of work that whatever it is that you're going to handle, you're being trained on how to at least handle those different types of situations. Are you going to cover every situation? No, but you're going to at least have a good foundation to that you can reference to. Right. So I've been in those
times. And if I'm not doing my job, I mean, instead of this is gratuitously not doing your job.
Right.
I'm not going to still be able to stick around. And if I'm doing something that's illegal, then I'm going to get arrested and I'm going to get prosecuted. And I'm going to get convicted without a doubt.
Right, exactly. Like if I do something wrong in my job, yeah, I'm there's going to be consequences for me. whether it could be from wrong. A penalty.
You're killing him,
what I'm saying.
That's what I mean. Yeah, that's what I mean. If I'm doing something that's wrong and illegal.
Yeah,
like murder.
Yeah,
doing something wrong is fucking taking a fucking roll of toilet paper home because you're like right, no good. Right. I don't want to stop on the way home.
Well, but I'm saying like if I like even as a contracting officer, if I there are rules and regulations that I have to follow. If I break those rules and regulations or don't acknowledge them or ignore them, there's a penalty that I could potentially maximum. I could go to jail I could be reprimanded.
But imagine doing that on camera.
Right. But that's what I'm saying. Like with them, that should be the equivalence. Like they have rules and regulations they follow, but they're not being held accountable to it.
But the new rule and regulation has become, I fear for my life.
You know what? And I'm just thinking about something else too. With you guys being a military, if you get perspective on this, it seems to me that there are more rules being followed in combat zones.
Than
there is like walking a beat.
Duh.
Bruh,
you know what I mean?
I've been shot at. You got to make sure that a nigga shot at you. You got to make sure that fucking weapon wasn't his weapon.
Yeah.
And depending on where you at, you got to call up and say, hey, somebody just shot at us. Are we clear to shoot back at them?
Right.
And then you have whole questioning. If you answer yes, like they're shooting at us, then they'll be like, okay, well, did you identify where the direction was coming from? Mm-hmm. Do you know the caliber of weapon?
What's that word? Know, the colors they're wearing and shit. To fill out, nigga.
Do you know what direction the wind was? Did you hear the guy next to him farting? Right. And it's like,
and this is when you have a true enemy trying to take you out.
Yes.
Well, and you still have to follow these procedures.
Bro.
Yes.
Got carte blanche to just walk up in hotel rooms and just Rayfield people. It don't make sense to me.
To be honest, we had about a 72-hour window where there was no rules of engagements. Like, that means literally whatever came in front of us, we were free to shoot.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, whatever, regardless of what happened to them, we weren't going to be prosecuted or charged or none of that shit. But then the rules got lifted, and it was like they became, you know, no longer if a vehicle crosses your path, you can't. You have to identify. You have to let them see where they were going. Basically, the vehicle had to explode in front of you before you could actually say, "Hey, that was an enemy." And then even if you were I was shot at. Like our group was shot at, and you could hear the fucking ding, 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 ding. I'm like, yo, and here we are on the radio. Like, yo, we're being shot at. You know, I'm hearing the dings paying off the armor. He's like, okay, well, do you know what direction? Like, no, because I'm not gonna I'm not gonna poke my head out.
Man, I'm not trying to catch a bullet.
So nigga, it's like
being shot at,
bro. It's
right.
And even then, okay, hold on. Even then, we had to go.
That does not.
We had
make
to go
sense.
Back to the fucking.
I understand
file.
That you're following those rules, and I hear and I understand the reason for that.
And every ammo that we expelled,
why isn't that police that are in a much less precarious position not allowed, expected to follow some type of regulation similar to that?
But that makes it worse, though. And that's why I have less sympathy for them. I feel like they should be fucking harder on them, though. Because every time I went back to the FOB and I expelled anything,
I had to
count that ammo. And let me be off by one.
You're saying the same thing.
Yes.
No, I'm saying, but society is brought into this whole thing of the, and once again, like I said, dog, police, this fucking law enforcement, this whole thing, they have been much safer than they have been in like previous years. Dog, you talk about the fucking police being capped up in the 80s and early 90s, talking about the crack era to now.
Yeah, way different.
Come on, way different, bro. But ain't nobody spitting them facts except for like people like us.
When they were dealing with the gangs and the mob and all that sort of thing.
I tell people all the time, man, I had two parents who were cops during the crack era who somehow found a way not to shoot niggas who were unarmed in the back.
Yeah.
And I'm like, and I leave it at that, dog. I leave it at that. And I say, you say what you want, preach your rhetoric, but I had two parents who were police during the crack era in Kansas City, Missouri, dog. When we was talking about, when we was hitting like motherfucking East St. Louis numbers, nigga, who found a way not to shoot niggas in the back.
Right. When it was hot. I mean, yeah, because you talking about that 80s and early 90s, man. You talking about, you know, because that's when the Bloods and Crips showed up. Yeah, the Jamaicans. Them Jamaicans, man. Because, you know, kind of Bloods and Crips kind of wasn't in there now.
I don't know if you remember, we even had a little nigga down at Gillen Park, the little serial killer that was snatching up prostitutes.
Yeah, that was going on. I remember that. Yeah.
Yeah, nigga, it's like, I get it. You want the police to be, I don't know the word, dog, but you just don't want them to just go above and beyond the law so much where, like, everybody getting killed, nigga. You're not police anymore. You're the fucking Gestapo.
Yeah, you don't right. have to be above the law.
That's though. What it is. Are you a police department or are you a kill squad?
And once again, that's what
it's turning into.
Yeah, because it's that whole thing where, like football players, like in, I don't know if it's a poor analogy or not, but people say, you know, people like, well, they knew they were getting into with these CTIs and CTEs and these injuries, this and that. And I'm like, but didn't police know they were getting into as far as like when they signed up for this fucking dangerous ass job? Mm.
You don't get drafted to become a police officer.
Did they not know that a motherfucking bullet was coming, they might be coming that way? When I signed up to be a medic, I knew that, hey, I might be
Wait a minute, didn't Trump tell that to the one lady's one guy's
yeah, wife? He knew he signed up for.
Yeah, he knew what he signed up for. Quit crying.
We all do, but for some, I don't know, dog. I just like niggas just. And once again, when I say niggas for me is like just everybody, dog. Just like niggas is just fucking. That's why Jay's laughing, because he know I'd be like, niggas is everybody. Just like motherfuckers would be like, just like, how did you not know it's what you were signed up for? And I get it. And like, just like, yeah, you signed up for it, and there should be some kind of leeway given to you. But when you on video making a nigga do the motherfucking hokey pokey before you shoot him in the head, come on, bro. That should be automatic jail time, bro. I really want to know who these people were on that jury so I can look at them and be like, what did y'all see?
Right.
There has to be a 20 second snippet video that was cut out.
Yeah. And you know, just kind of thinking over that whole scenario again, just the way he escalates the situation when you really should be trying to keep the situation as calm as possible, because the outcome is supposed to be for everybody to come out of the situation safe.
Exactly.
And you don't do that by escalating the situation and making it more complicated, and actually putting everybody in danger by having, when you had him on the ground and you had him flat, both of them, that was the safest situation you could be in to execute your search and detain them.
Cause what does that show you though? That he's compliant though. Cause like I it's not even law enforcement. We talk about man, what we went through it's like, okay, I come into a room. Here's this fucking client or kid or teenager that's fucking just been beating somebody over the head. Now all of a sudden, James comes into the room and says, "Hey, I need you to get on the ground." And this kid, for some reason, reacts to James in a way that they haven't, and they get on the ground. Go, whatever the kid. So let's just say the kid's name is Jessica. Hey, Jessica, this is James. For some odd reason, you're reacting to me. I'm gonna need you to just lay there, calm down, breathe, put your hands out.
Mm-hmm.
As a matter of fact, now think about it. If you hear me, you understand what I'm saying. I'm gonna need you to cross your legs. And Jessica crosses her legs. So that means she's compliant and she's reacting to James. So why couldn't this cop have said, "Hey, what's your name, man?" my name is blah 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 blah. My name is Shaver. What was his first name? I can't remember.
Daniel, wasn't it?
Hey, Daniel. My name is Daniel. Hey, Daniel. I want to go home. I want you to get home. I want you and your old lady to get home.
Mm-hmm.
Your old lady is safe. She's back here with us right now. So what I'm gonna need you to do is keep your hands out. Keep your fingers spread. Keep your legs crossed. I'm going to approach you now, Daniel. When I approach you and put my hands on you, I don't want you to jump at all. I'm going to search you. What's wrong with that?
Because he don't get to play Billy Badass if he takes that approach. He wants to prove everybody how tough he is and how badass he is.
Hey, nigga. Hey, I don't believe in God. But when I die, I don't want nobody's on my mind. You know what I'm saying, bro?
Mm-hmm.
I don't believe in God. I don't believe in heaven, nigga, but when I'm laying there in my bed, I don't want, unless you had it coming, I don't want you on my mind, bro. I want Maury, and I want my kids. I want my nigga James. I want my nigga Frank and his children.
Mm-hmm.
Joe, Jeff. I want all that to be on my mind. I don't want some nigga who I fucking shot in the head off just GP on my brain. I don't get it.
Mm-mm. So,
hey, you see that, Frank? Yeah, he got me there. He's moving the screen around.
Oh, I'm here. Excuse me.
So, hey, James.
Yo.
What do you think about Trump going to the Mississippi Civil Rights Museum?
Oh, I didn't hear about that one.
No. Trump didn't go there. He didn't go to the Civil Rights Museum.
Huh?
No, he didn't. He didn't go.
He did go.
No, he addressed it. He canceled the actual invitation only. He only addressed it like in a fucking, I don't know, interview or whatever the fuck. He didn't go.
Okay.
Yeah, because when I first read it, I thought that he actually, because they said that he ignored all the.
Oh, right. Because that was the thing where I can't stand her. Sarah Tuckley Sanders was criticizing John Lewis.
Hey, why do her eyes not like each other?
I can't stand that for man.
Look, Denise.
Why does she seem assertive and amused all at the same time, nigga?
Right.
Listen, we here.
No,
nigga, we will not make fun of your disabilities at all. So. Not saying that she has one, but I'm just saying.
Trump ignores backlash, visits Mississippi Civil Rights Museum and praises civil rights. Am I reading this wrong?
No, that's what I thought too. Because when I read it, I thought that he actually visited, but all he did was just addressed it.
It. Okay. Now this headline is
right. I was like, because to me, I was like, well, he ignored like everybody telling him not to come.
I read it, but even if you read it, nigga, it's confusing.
No, I know. That's why you have to keep reading it, because he just.
Nigga, I read it, and I'm like, until you said, I was like, oh, wait a minute.
I had to read it a couple of times. Trust me, dog. I had to make sure.
He even says instead of attending the opening.
I did hear him double down on backing Roy Moore.
Oh yeah,
I did hear that.
I just saw that he just finished recording the calls.
The fucking R. Kelly of Republicans, nigga.
Right.
Hold on. Yeah, go ahead talk about it. I had a clip. Yeah, say, oh boy, he was talking about. Well, back in my grandma's days, women was getting married when they was 14 to 15.
They doing anything they can to try to justify this foolishness.
Yeah, it says Trump records robocalls for Roy Moore.
Yeah,
I heard about that.
He just gave a speech where he would back them, double down and backing them up, and tried to make it sound, you know, was talking about one of the victims, you know, saying that she was full of shit and all that sort of thing. You know, I mean, just like, this is real low life shit, man. I mean, this.
I just hope Mr. Roberto Mueller, because I'm going to call him for Roberto from now on. I just hope I'm going to be patient. And I hope this case is like airtight, nigga. Like airtight, dog. Air fucking tight, dog.
You talking about just Trump?
Because it has to be. It has to be airtight, dog. There is no room.
Yeah, I got a feeling they're not going to be able to. I just don't think they're going to be able to find enough evidence and corroborate.
Oh, I think they already have it. It's just that there's so many times you could come up with charges.
All guys. I don't even have Trump.
Exactly. But I don't think they have enough things that are going to directly implicate Trump enough to actually prosecute him.
Get me wrong. I'm saying like James Green. Like I'm saying, don't get me wrong. It's going to dirty up and sully what Trump's been saying. What Trump's been saying all along, but it's gonna be it's gonna make his presidency, it's gonna tarnish or shitty his presidency, but it's not gonna be enough to get him fucking impeached.
Because look, I had a story saved about the emails that Donald Trump Jr. because he reneged on his previous statement saying that he never discussed it with his dad. The meeting in last June.
Or at Trump Towers.
But now it comes to light that he actually did share that shit with his dad. Because initially it was like he didn't. Then it was like, oh, he went to the quote unquote publicist, the director of publicists or whatever. Right.
And so see, you might get, they need more than just people that lied under oath type thing.
Like,
this is what they really need. This is what they really, really need. And they need more than collusion. They need quid pro quo. They've got to prove.
Well, that's the one with Flynn.
The Russians something in return.
That's what Flynn is doing.
That's going to be a silver bullet.
Yeah, that's what they got with Flynn right now. They got Flynn actually saying. To the Russians or whatever the fuck he was talking to, saying that, hey, y'all gotta chill with these whatever sanctions. You guys gonna be all right. So that's what they're pursuing now. That's why
Enough though, because that's not really that unusual.
No, I'm just saying that
an incoming administration would
be with the ambassador, with
a foreign government, you know, and say, you know, when our administration comes in, this is gonna happen type thing. The only way that would stick as if in return for you helping us get elected, we will make sure that these sanctions won't stick. If they have that, then they got something. But for them just to say, don't worry about it, these sanctions won't stick, there's no give and take, that it just give.
I think the only thing bad thing is like I think that it's going there. Yeah. It's just I want it to be
find,
so.
The guy to find the evidence.
I want it to be.
Day. Don't know what you know is what you can prove.
Yeah, I guess like right here. Like for me, it's like I wanted it to happen already, so I don't have to go through this shit.
What's that?
That was training day.
That's training day?
Yeah.
You sure that wasn't the one with Jamie Foxx?
Which one?
With Jamie Foxx.
The one with Jamie Foxx and.
Talking about Miami Vice.
It was Jamie Foxx. It was the one with Jamie Foxx and old boy from 300. It's not what you know, but you can prove.
Oh, law abiding citizen.
Yeah, he said that.
They might have said something similar in that.
Yeah. I mean, dog, that's a common thing, though.
No, but he does that in training day. He says that to Ethan Hawke. Because it don't matter what you know, it's what you can prove.
It said the same thing though. He said not what you know, but what you can prove. And,
I'm not saying they didn't say it in that movie.
I'm saying you're right. No, I said you're right. It's the same thing.
Yeah. But that's it. It don't matter what we think we know or how it all looks. If we don't have the evidence to prove it in court, enough to prove it in court, and none of it matters. It's all just speculation and hearsay, and you know, it's not enough.
Yep, I agree.
So, I mean, just hope, you know, just keep digging and maybe something They're looking for that silver bullet. I know they are.
Yeah,
they,
I ain't never been under no pretense that Trump. It's going to be either that motherfucker just resigns or he just goes to the next election cycle. But I never thought they only him on some motherfucking impeachment shit.
Yeah, I don't think so either.
I think fucking with him is with Mueller. Like you have one shot, one kill. You only have one opportunity, dog.
I think it's gonna be some dominoes that fall, but it's not gonna be the ones that people want.
It'll be all around. Yeah. I mean, there's players
I
think Kushner's gonna be real key.
It's gonna be the whole thing that niggas thought would happen with Michael Vick, where motherfuckers would be like, "Hey, Vick, I got you, dog. I'm gonna take the hit for you." It's gonna be the same thing. It's gonna be, except now these motherfuckers gonna take the hit for Trump, bro. They gonna take the hit from him because you think about it, all these motherfuckers rich, all these motherfuckers got lawyers on call, and they ain't really gonna do no time.
Nah.
And that's what's gonna be. It's gonna be a lot of motherfuckers saying, "Hey, I got you. Take care of me." At the end, I think
Kushner's gonna be the big one. And as much as
they're pressure, what are you gonna say? What are you gonna do?
I think that's because he's the one that directed. They're saying that he directed Flynn to communicate with Russia.
But here's the thing though: if he takes the fall, then what?
No, yeah. I'm saying that he might be. Well, it depends. If he takes the fall and willy nilly and not answer anything, then he's taking the fall. What?
He gets 2 years in federal prison.
I don't know.
Yeah, he's family. He ain't gonna turn on him.
That's what I'm saying, bro.
That's his son-in-law.
He'll get 2 years in some federal camp somewhere.
No, you ain't family. If you're not blood, you're not family, dog. And you know Trump don't gives a fuck, though.
He cares about loyalty.
No, I'm talking about Kush is not going. Kush is going to be loyal because
he's that's what I'm saying.
Okay.
All I'm saying, no, I feel you. I want it to happen? Do I want the dominoes to fall? I just don't see it happening, bro.
I think it's a slim to none type proposition.
All right.
I think you're going to continue to see the pieces around Trump fall, but I don't think you'll see him fall.
You look at the same thing as like motherfucking Ali North, bro. Somehow, some way, all these motherfucking generals convinced us to believe that some colonel was the one that orchestrated all this bullshit. You know what I'm saying, bro?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know how the army work. So now all of a sudden I'm supposed to believe that Colonel or Ali North was the one that orchestrated all these motherfucking illegal gun deals to the Contras? Okay. I got you. You know what I'm saying? That's what's going to be happening, man.
That's like, did you see that Tom Cruise movie just made? That American Made?
I haven't seen it, but I do want to see it.
Man, I haven't seen it either.
That goes deeper into the whole Iran-Contra thing, and you know, it's partially based on a true story.
Yeah.
You got to peep that, man, for real.
Yeah, I'm want to watch it, bro. I thought, except for that one horrible-ass Eyes Wide Shut that he made, I thought Tom Cruise for real, bro.
I've been a Tom Cruise fan.
Hey, dog. Me and Dave went to see that shit, though.
I kind of knew that was
going to
be. Yeah.
That nigga Dave was stood up in the middle of the theater and said, if I hear this nigga play this piano one more time. I'm done, nigga. Hey, speaking of movies, have you seen The Foreigner? Nice segue.
Oh, yeah. That was good, man.
Hey, this may be the first movie that I've never seen Jackie Chan smiling.
I know.
In
Jackie was so cold, man.
Hey, the name of the movie should have been Tell Me Their Names, nigga.
Yes.
Hey, Frank, you still there?
Was real good, man, too, man. Pierce Brosnan.
Hold on, Frank, you still there?
To the hill, man.
Yeah, I'm here.
You want to stop talking about the movie?
No, I'm just saying. I'm listening. I'm taking it all in.
Okay, yeah. I know. No homo, like spoilers.
What?
I said I know some people don't like spoilers. So
spoiler alert.
Spoil away, dog.
Spoiler alert.
Dog, spoiler, Jackie Chan is mad.
Jackie Chan was so cold in that
one. Even though, I ain't gonna say nothing, but Moira's a little bit of racist. She said, why would this movie called The Chinaman?
Well, the episode is not going to be it's called China.
Or what they just call it, Chink.
Let me just get off right now.
What?
Okay, it won't be that late.
You in trouble?
Say what?
You in trouble?
Yeah.
I'm always in trouble.
Oh. Trouble man, China man.
Yeah. Still will be a Chinaman.
So,
But no, that was a real good movie, though, actually.
It was like they spent like 5 minutes on. Like, you really couldn't even gauge Jackie Chan's relationship with his daughter because she got blew the fuck up in the
immediately.
Damn.
Immediately. I mean, about 5 minutes in. His daughter was dead and blown to bits.
So what other movies have you guys watched?
Jackie lost his shit immediately.
Hey, dog, that nigga said,
sat up in the police office for like every day for like 3 weeks or something like that.
Hey, dog, he's being reasonable, dog. What's their names? I just need to know the names.
Right. And Pierce Brosnan tried to play ball. Like, who's this little chink that keeps calling me?
If you give me their names, I will help y'all out. Hey, dog. Hey. That nigga Jackie, dog.
They dragged him out of there, and then he blew up the bathroom, and he was like, oh, wait a minute.
Dog, but how long, dog? This is the one thing that made me mad, though. They really, really, really waited till like the... maybe near the end of the second part of the movie to figure out who this nigga was.
Oh, that he was like ex-military and all that shit.
Yeah, because soon as this nigga show up, and as soon as he built like some simple ass bomb in my bathroom,
that's true. Like, who? Especially since Pierce Brosnan had all the hookups, he knew everybody.
Right, and they proved the fact that he could get the information near the end of the second part of the movie, you know what I'm saying? The second score in the movie. So it's like, I'm like, as soon as you show up, I'm like, okay, whatever, nigga. But as soon as you show up and there's a bomb in my building, nigga, I'm finding out who you are immediately.
Right.
That's the only part of the movie I didn't like. It's like, wait a minute. I don't give a fuck about fucking spoilers, whatever. So I already heard the spoilers and the reviews and shit. So I was like, wait a minute. These niggas waited till this long in the movie to figure out who this nigga was?
Yeah. I kind of felt like Pierce Brosnan was dirty early on, though.
But then he wasn't really dirty, though.
Yeah, he was.
No. He wasn't dirty. His wife, and them other niggas. No.
He was the one dude that he kept. They was in it together, remember?
No, he wasn't. The old dude that he capped betrayed him. Because remember, it was his wife and that old dude who betrayed him, and his wife had
He knew the explosives were going to happen. This black was supposed to get killed, though.
When?
Because that was... Remember, the whole reason they were doing that is so that Britain would give them concessions.
Right. But remember...
I'm saying...
The
way this whole thing started off, he was in on it from the beginning, but he didn't think he was going to go this far. But he was dirty from jump. That's why he went to jail.
Who? Remember, he got motherfucking murked.
When he supposed to go to jail? Because wait a minute. Because then Jackie Chan showed up at the end with the proof.
Hold on. No. No, dog. You remember Pierce. He, for the most part, he was on the up and up. his wife and the old dude he cat betrayed him. Then his nephew was fucking his wife, and his wife was getting the information from his nephew, remember?
No, but wait a minute. But one of the people that was on the bomb squad was his girl that it was in the restaurant that Jackie called him with.
No, no, no. The girl was remember, old dude was using the old girl to trick him, the information too. But remember, Jack, but remember the old dude said, it all comes around. We all get caught up in this. And Jackie Chan's character had misinterpreted the fact that he was kissing that chick for the fact that Pierce was in on it too. And he wasn't. That's why he killed old boy. Remember, he killed old boy. He was like, wait a minute, man. Watch it again, bro. Remember, Pierce said, when him and old, because remember, he was so mad that he was like, yeah, I went to jail. I did all this time for this shit, but I'm trying to be about that nonviolence. And he was real about that shit. And old boy, me and Moy was watching, and I was like, I bet you that shit come back. But I didn't know how it come back to bite him. So remember, when old boy came, he brought old boy to his house, he killed him. And he was like, we weren't supposed to be about this, and that. And then old boy said, he was like, matter of fact, hold on, backtrack. Because remember, the wife was mad at Pierce's character because he didn't do shit about his brother's killing.
She wanted him to go back to the old days, his old IRA way.
Yes, that was the whole overarching thing was that Pierce was like,
she thought he was a punk because he wanted
let the four dudes that got her brother killed,
right?
He didn't kill them. Old boy was like, well, your wife this and that, and the net member, his nephew was fucking his wife.
That's right. Yeah.
That's what it was.
There was so much scandal going on.
Yeah, and the thing was, his nephew, Pierce's character, and the nephew were both being played.
Mm-hmm.
That's why, remember, at the end of the movie, the nephew showed up and capped old girl.
Mm-hmm.
Because he was like, hold up, bitch. I thought you loved me. And she was like, nah, young nigga, I was putting this pussy on you so I can get this information.
Right.
He capped her off. And remember how mad Pierce was at old boy? He was like, we weren't supposed to be about this, yada, 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 this, and that. And right. that was the saving grace for Jackie Chan's character was with the black dude, because the black dude was the one dude who knew everything as far as the British.
Oh, the commander.
He was like, that's why he was like, you know what, let him, remember that at the end of the movie, they had the drop squad on Jackie's Chinese restaurant. He was like, let him slide.
Yeah. Oh, man. Jackie showed up at the apartment or whatever.
But remember, Jackie showed up because the only thing Jackie knew was, I took a picture of you with this bitch. And when I showed up at this house, this bitch was here.
Mm-hmm.
You had to be in on it. What you remember is what Jackie said was in the movie. Jackie said, you've been lying to me all along.
Yeah.
And Pierce was like, hold on, my man. But all Jackie had to go off was, you was kissing this bitch. And when I showed up to the house, this bitch was here.
Mm-hmm.
But Jackie didn't know that she'd been playing Pierce's character all along.
Right. Okay. All right.
You know what I'm saying? Go back and watch it, though.
I'm going to rewatch it, though.
I watch it again, too, because at first I was fucked up, but Moy was like, yeah. She been playing everybody. But the thing that I remember was that the little fat, the reporter in the airport.
Mm.
Remember the whole, they did the battery swap?
Right. Oh, that was cold-blooded. That's what made
me remember that she was playing everybody. The little chick that was fucking...
Because she hooked up with him and switched out the laptop.
Because I think Maury was changing the baby's diapers at the time when they met at the bar. Remember, he was on his laptop, and then she pulled up and said, you need to have a real whiskey. And then Moy didn't see that. Go back and watch it again.
I'm gonna watch it again.
It's like 30 minutes where Jackie Chan ain't even in the movie, nigga.
Right. Yeah. It's almost. It almost was like a. Jackie was almost a side character almost.
Mm-hmm.
It really focused around Pierce Brosnan's character, really.
Like the first 40 minutes, it's like Jackie Pierce, Jackie blowing up people, Jackie blowing up this nigga, Jackie Pierce. Right,
Pierce. He had motherfuckers shook. Jackie had niggas shook.
And then it's like we just said, like 30 minutes of just ain't, like, I'm like, damn, what, did Jackie Chan die? Like, right. No Jackie Chan.
That's when they start giving you the meat of the whole scandal.
Yeah, what's going on, all the fuckery. But right. Because at first, because remember they had that meeting, like in the first like 30 minutes of the movie, they had all the heads of all the old school niggas who like then became like official.
Right, because he wanted to check everybody's arsenal and all that sort of thing.
Yeah, so like she was like, yeah, Pierce is dirty. I said, that just seems too like straightforward. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. I said, but he could be dirty, you know? And come to find out, like, he was a little dirty, but he didn't know that, like, everybody in his life was fucking him over. He was getting fucked over by his wife, by his nephew, and by the chick who he thought he was fucking his wife over with.
Yeah.
Yep.
And, you know, I know Jackie got older and that sort of thing, but he was still pretty cold.
Hey, now he, like, in the beginning of the movie, he had that like, I got two hot knees walk.
Yeah. When he had to get out the little bed and breakfast place or whatever.
Yeah. Hey, when them niggas started coming for him, nigga, he was like the old Jackie Chan. Hey, when he was fighting but I was telling Maury, though, that's like one of the things I love about like Jackie Chan movies is, like, you know, you see these other movies where like, it's like these niggas, hey, you can't hit them, you can't touch them. They just so cold with the kung fu, or so cold with their discipline. Like Jackie Chan, he always get fucked up in the, like he wins, but he always take a beating. You know what I'm saying?
He falls upstairs. Jackie Chan and anybody associated with a Jackie Chan production cannot be insured by any insurance company on the planet.
But I'm saying it's like on screen, it's like he literally takes that beating. You know what I'm saying? Agree. Like it's like, yeah, I'm cold with the kung fu, but realistic kung fu fighting. Like if it's three niggas fighting me, I'm gonna get fucked up. I may win, but I'm still gonna get fucked up.
Yeah, you know, I saw a little thing on that Jackie Chan just about his rise to his career and all that sort of thing. And he talks about how he tried to be like Bruce Lee at first. You know, when Bruce Lee died, he was supposed to be the heir apparent, you know. So he tried to make Bruce Lee type movies and, you know, they just weren't, he wasn't Bruce Lee, so it didn't work out. They were popular, but they weren't great. And then when he started putting doing his own thing and doing like the high risk stuff and adding the comedy and that sort of thing. And that's when he became like a superstar, when he did it his way instead of the way he thought it needed to be done in order to be popular.
Yeah. I mean, I guess I like the fight scenes, like with him, the little fat dude, and then like the old boy, was it Ramsay Bolton from like the Game of Thrones?
I
like his character too, but it's like, Of course, I'm Jackie Chan. I'm like, you know, kung fu masters, so many disciplines. But if I'm fighting two dudes in the stairway, niggas gonna get their shots off on me. You know what I'm saying? And he was getting his face.
I like how Jackie just used whatever's available.
Yeah, but I'm saying, he makes it so much more realistic with that. You know what I'm saying? Right. You like see a Steven Seagal movie where he goes into a bar and like he fight eight Jamaicans and don't nobody touch him. It's like, okay, nigga, a couple of Jamaicans, you know,
and Jackie's real fit. You know, like Jackie, you know, if he gets thrown into a bookcase, he feels it. You know what I mean? It's like, oh, you know, he gets hurt. Hey, and you can tell he's hurt.
Yeah, because it was like a couple of scenes where I was like, Jackie got here for real, because like that face he made. That motherfucker hit him with that board for real, dog.
Right.
Ain't no acting, ain't no enough acting. But like, anyway, We me and James are gonna always say, if you have not seen The Foreigner,
you should definitely see The Foreigner.
Or as Maury said, just what she say his name of the movie should be
The Chinaman.
Well, nah, I was just fucking around, but she said the name of this movie should be "Give Me the Names," because all he kept saying was "Give me the names." Oh shit! Hey, Frank, you still there?
I'm still here.
We ran off on a tangent for it.
Oh, my bad, but hey, dog, that's a good movie, bro.
That's actually The Foreigner is one of the best movies I saw this year. I'm gonna be gone.
And just so you know, there's a book that it's based on a book called The Chinaman. So technically, Moore should be is right. Like, no lie, that's what I was looking at.
It really based on a book called Chinaman.
Yeah.
It's not, nigga. You're a
liar. I'm dead ass, dog. Like,
nigga, put it on the screen, nigga.
Hold on. The Chinaman, dog. That's what I was looking at. I was like, yeah. I'm putting it on right now. Hold on.
You doing a lot of searching for a nigga that had the facts up already.
Well, I had it on my phone. I didn't want to, because you know this shit will audio play shit. No, not here.
That's fucked up. It was actually based on some shit called the time.
Where was it at? Where the fuck was it?
Duh, how did you not have this saved up already?
Cool. I heard. I'm coming out with a sequel.
The Chinaman is a thriller novel in my phone, nigga. That's right.
Is it the Chinaman? They're going to come out with a sequel.
Chinaman is the fourth. It's the fourth novel.
Oh my god, nigga.
No, but if you look at the other ones though, if you look at the other ones that he wrote, it's like fucking.
But hold on, I mean they do leave it open to like go on.
True.
Cause like at the like Maury pointed out, like the black dude at the end was like yada yada yada, there's no need to wake the dragon now. And then he was having a flashback, so they can delve into that. So they do leave it open for a lot of prequels and sequels.
Yeah, because you got the fireman.
The fireman. It's Hungry China Ghost, right there.
China You're man. Right. The vets. Because,
when I saw the trailer for it,
his titles are not very intricate. The Mind Maker, the Double Tap, the Burpee.
What?
The Double Tap.
The Double Tap. I mean, nah, it's not what you was thinking, nigga. It's not the DP, nigga. It's the Double Tap.
Well, you know, they call it Double Tap sometimes.
That is true. You are correct, sir. Hold on, dog. All right, Frank, you get into it. Nigga, let's go.
I gotta roll off in a second.
Yeah, I get off here too in a bit.
But anyway, so okay, I guess we get out. Yeah, I'm not gonna do this now. I was gonna do the Grammys stuff, but we could do the Grammys another day.
You'll do it another day. And nigga, ain't nobody watch no Grammys.
I've been done with the Grammys for years.
Well, we got a lot of we got people of color being nominated for Record of the Year, so we'll do that next time.
All you need to know is that Baker Mayfield won the Heisman for being the Patriot. That might be fuck a Grammy. The biggest Itwine of the year is Baker Mayfield, nigga. And once again, I say, for all the people who don't know, Itwine means if that was a nigga, could you imagine motherfucking any nigga grabbing his touch on the sidelines of any motherfucking stadium and then we win the Heisman. But anyway.
No. It wouldn't happen.
Like I said, he ain't nothing but motherfucking Johnny Manziel 2.0 to me, dog.
Yeah, nah, he's gonna be garbage.
So until he proves otherwise, dog, I don't hear shit. I took Frank, go ahead.
Oklahoma quarterbacks don't really do well in the beginning.
Nigga, they explode. Bradford, nigga.
I mean, he's still around, but he ain't doing it.
He around, where's nigga. He at? He been held together by motherfucking twisty ties right now, ain't he?
Where's Bradford at?
Is he hurt again? Who knows?
That was St. Louis.
Bradford, wasn't he at Minnesota?
Yeah, he was.
He had two good games, and that nigga sneezed and fell apart, nigga.
No, right.
All right, though.
So once again, dog, like I said, dog, I'm just waiting for him to fail so I can hit Hodge up and be like, hey, what's up, Oklahoma, nigga? In y'all quarterback situation. Because y'all might be the Alabama's of quarterbacks, nigga. Because Alabama don't produce no motherfucking real running backs. Y'all might be the Alabama quarterbacks, nigga. What's up?
Are you an Oklahoma fan?
Who?
James?
Who?
Nah, he ain't no Oklahoma fan. He just said, yeah, you're right. Oh. Well, since KU ain't got no football team, he is a...
Oh, Lord.
He is a... What are you, Florida State?
Huh? Who I root for? I don't really actually root for any team football-wise. I got teams I'm more inclined to. I used to be a Michigan fan back in the day.
You hear that, Frank?
Yeah, I hear that. Yes. Wah, 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 wah.
Anyway, yeah, me and college football, I got a very loose relationship with college football.
Hey, Dice, you sound like a motherfucker that been divorced 3 times, nigga.
Anyway, let's close this shit out, man.
Hey, Frank, he ain't been the same since Mangino left.
Nope.
No one has, dog.
I knew, man, when they left, I said, man, that's a mistake. I said, it's going to be bad.
I ain't going to lie, dog. That shit, I don't know why he let that nigga leave, because he was motherfucking telling niggas to stop being bitches, pretty much. Right.
Man, I'm telling you, man, he didn't fit the right image, man.
Hey, dog.
Fat Italian dude wearing lure suits on the sidelines. They couldn't.
Hey, I don't know how
much as they could take.
No, you throw those for velour, dog.
I thought they were like pussy. Shut up and go run. See, I don't know.
All right, dog, we're reaching, dog. Come on, let's close this shit out.
All right.
Got gold link over here.
Thank you once again, everybody. I am the Casey Stork. She see money all around me. Yeah, ooh, I feel like I'm the man. Anyway, I'm the Casey Stork. Once again, thank y'all for listening. I'm my homeboy, James, that came in the last minute to save us from our own man.
James J, a.k.a. the Arrogant Desperado.
I got my homeboy, 30 Pieces of AG up in Topeka, man. We are the Rockin' Podcast, and we out.
Enjoy the music. Ass nigga with a sick ass mouth and a slick ass flow. Got your bitch around me, nigga. Ain't a plan when I'm coming for the kitty. Got my full goddamn. Do it for my niggas and the ghost right there. Do it for my niggas and the ghost right now. Niggas got killed for the boy, living dreams in the hills, and they watching for the boy right now. Goddamn, what a time, what a year. We are what them young boys feel. I kill, never be killed. That's real, no lie. You can tell it from my peers right now. Don't you wanna fuck me now? Don't you wanna love me down? Girl, you can't tie me down like Ray J said, but no, I'm down. Freaking nigga, show me something. Shake it like it on me.